Donovan Smithy?
Yeah.
Charlie Chazelle.
Nice to meet you. How are you doing?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm doing all right. You know, you look young to be a journalist.
And that's why I write for the internet, so no one knows.
Yeah.
So, when we were on the phone earlier, I was really fascinated with what you were telling me.
Yeah. I know it probably doesn't make any sense, and it's probably fake to you.
Well, I have a slight recollection from when I was around your age, but that's not the point. I did some research, and some big articles mentioned it back in 2005, but they didn't have a clue.
Odd.
Very. That's why I wanted to hear your perspective, so that we could figure this out and get a good story out of it.
Yeah, I got that.
Alright, so for the sake of the article, just give me a recap of what this entity was.
Well, in a nutshell, there's this kid show that I used to watch a lot of growing up. It was like this weird, low-budget puppet show. It had pirates and talking fish, and every episode they fought off aliens. It was weird. And I found out years later that this strange show wasn't real. It was only in my head, apparently, and all that time I was actually looking at a static screen. So when I was seeing Blondebeard the pirate fighting off Martians, my parents saw nothing. Just static.
Did your parents ever tell you this when you were young?
They did once. I never believed it because, I mean, I thought it was silly. They never mentioned it again because I guess they thought I was using my active imagination. I don't even know what the show was called, but damn it, I still have that theme stuck in my head. Yeah, you know.
It's interesting that you vividly remember something that never even existed.
Yeah, and that's why I get so confused about it.
I read some theory that said that this TV show could only be seen by younger viewers. Kind of similar to how, like, older people can't hear higher-pitched sounds, but younger people can.
Well, it would make sense.
Yeah. Now, tell me more about your experience with this show.
Well, I was 6 when I started watching it. It was on every Tuesday morning. I'd usually have it on when I was eating breakfast and waiting for the bus. My mom would always tell me to not watch it for too long because it would hurt my eyes.
Who all was in the house with you when you were watching this show?
I lived with my brother, Andy, and my mom. My dad was there sometimes, but my mom said he was always at work. I don't think that was true. And Andy, he was always more mature than me. He was born a year earlier. We didn't have much growing up. We lived in an apartment complex, and I didn't have much to do.
Did they ever interact with the show that you were watching?
Barely. I would always draw pictures of it, and like I said before, my mom would see that as me being creative and using my imagination, which I guess makes sense now. They only watched the show once with me, but it was only for like 2 minutes. I think they got worried about me watching it for a couple months.
Now, I assume since you didn't have much, this was a pretty vital piece of entertainment, so when did you stop watching it?
Well, I didn't want to stop watching it, but the doctors forced me to.
Wait. You got help for this?
Yeah, but not exactly on my own will. You see, it was a typical morning, nothing new. I was watching the show, and it's so weird, this alien-like figure starts walking up to me. I was terrified by it. My mom heard me scream and tried to calm me down. Then she told me that this show was messing with my brain and that I should stop watching it. But I never listened because that alien was still in the room. And I thought it was here to kill me. I was overwhelmed with this urge to protect myself, so I just started fighting it. It tried to resist and fought back. After I hit it several times, eventually I won. I knocked it down really hard on the floor. I thought my mom would be proud of me beating it, but instead, she was crying. She told me that I wasn't going to school that day, and took me to this large building, a mental institution. They didn't let me see Mom for years. I was eventually told that I was there because that alien I fought off was Andy. He was hospitalized, and he lost most of his memory. And the last thing he remembers of me is when I thought he was this strange creature and I fought him off.
I'm sorry about what you had to go through. I don't know what to say. Do you think that there's any way I could go back to your old apartment and just kind of go through what you lived through?
Sure. I don't know what you could find, though. It's been a while since I've been there.
Okay, what's the address?
So, this is where you lived?
That's the basement, but that's why I call home.
You didn't know about me, did she?
What?
You remember now, don't you? I can see in your face that you remember this place, this show, and me.
I don't understand.
Let me make it clear for you. Andy.
Andy?
You remember now? I'm your brother. Mother probably had you change your name to keep me away from you.
I don't remember this place. That can't be true.
Is it? Mom told me how you would always carry around a little journal to write down all your little stories. Tell me, isn't there a scar on the back of your head? Tell me! Yeah, and when you got out of the hospital, you moved away so you didn't have to remember what this place looked like.
What is wrong with you? Get a grip. I cannot be your brother.
Yeah? Then what is this?